Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Today is the 26th of August, the monthly expiry of August, and it was an interesting day. We opened with not the best global cues, and we gapped down slightly, but very quickly that got bought into. Reliance rocketed up in the morning, big short covering on the 2200 call. And more or less, my plan for the day was stay as risk averse as possible, because first of all, it's a monthly expiry. It can tend to be very tricky. Secondly, option premiums are super low. And third, I wanted to sort of take a little bit of a breather after two back-to-back stop-loss days. Obviously, there are two ways you can approach things in life. When you take a bad hit, you either take undue risk and try to, like, so-called make a big day happen, and that'll really end up messing you up. So that's not my approach. You can see at different points of time in the trade also ahead. Very good opportunities to maximize profit by trying to take a few trades, like I mentioned at different points, which trade I could potentially take. But I don't do that. I'm not that kind of a person. And in general, I would always reduce my risk whenever if I'm having two back-to-back days of taking a stop loss. Now, that being said, it was still a good day. I managed to close up about 7.5. And towards the end, I got really frustrated though because I made a stupid blunder. I was trying to create a double diagonal on both the Bank Nifty and Nifty. And on Nifty, first mistake I made was I executed it in MIS, and the broker that I use, Zerodha, once you execute in MIS, you cannot convert it. You have to square it off. So to slippage just there, I lost about 30,000. And then I had to retake the position in normal, not realizing that because of how Zerodha's thing works, my long calls, which are expiring today, did not get squared off because obviously, they're super OTM. Who's going to buy them if I sell them? And because of that, I can't buy monthly hedges. So, in the last minute is when I sort of realized that it didn't execute. So now, because of this error, I'm carrying 150 lots of Nifty overnight. And that's okay. It's my mistake. And honestly, if it ends up going against me, like it's not such a bad trade, but if it ends up going against me, it is super well deserved for not being very careful with checking the order before placing it. So, yeah, that's more or less what happened. And one more thing I want to talk about in today's intro is, like, I think a lot of people have got things a little bit wrong. Like, so yesterday, as a rhetorical question, my title was, "Is it time to change my strategy?" I think the exact analogy I gave was that no, it is not the time to change your strategy as soon as it slightly doesn't work in favor. But you put in the necessary risk management so that you don't continue to make it bleed if it is not the best overall circumstances for that strategy. And I think there is a very wrong perception that everyone has around taking losses. Like, I think this is just the wrong expectations that have been set by all the traders people follow online. Now, there are some really, really good traders online, and there are also some, I would say, dicey kind of people. And invariably, everyone only posts when they make profits, right? So you see a lot of mark-to-market screenshots, and some people do post their losses. That's there, but they majorly post like only their big mark-to-market gains, and nobody ever posts their losses. And trust me, nobody comes out when they're taking a super big loss. They don't come out and say, "Look, I took a super big loss today." They don't do that. So at Nifty VN, where we try to say, look, we're trying to set realistic expectations. You will take losses. Your performance is not measured over a week, a month. It's measured over years, right? So don't stop hating losses. And like I get a lot of these condolences. Oh, sorry about the loss. You'll make it up today. If you see today, I did not trade to make up my losses. I just tried to trade wherever there was an opportunity, and that's a wrong mindset. So completely accept these losses. Like we read in books all the time, accept the loss, but then in practice, people don't put it at all. They're like, "Oh shit, I made a loss." And they're going to be quite depressed about it. Anyway, going on extremely long over the intro. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a good day tomorrow, and I'll let you know tomorrow what happens with the trade that I entered by mistake towards the close. I'll hedge it right at the morning, so avoid any headache with that. Take care. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow.
Want to meet like-minded traders and discuss option strategies, adjustments, and more? Just type in "discuss Nifty" in your Telegram search box and join the friendly trader community.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The time is 9:37, and I entered my position around 9:33, 9:34. And basically, the idea is that more or less the 16,600 and 16,700 range for today is most likely to hold. And given the pricing of the 16,650, which is now at the money, we had a slight gap down because of negative global cues, but there is an immense amount of strength in Reliance. So Reliance is completely taking off today. And massive short covering in the 2200 call of the monthly expiry. So yesterday would have been just at the money, and today rocketed out of control. So that has basically bought the dip into the down move. And at this point, what I'm working with is that we have a high probability, higher probability of expiring closer to 16600, and between 16600 to 16650 is the range that I think we're most likely to expire. Of course, there can be a short covering that is triggered if we start testing around the 16700 mark, but that is something that we'll have to wait and see. More or less, my first half plan is to stay very far and really not deal with any kind of dealing with early morning shakeouts, and keep my distance. Currently, this strangle is trading about 8.5. And my idea is till either one of them expands to about 7+, I will not be making any changes to this position. So they're currently trading at 4.5 and 4 each. Let them expand to about 7 before I risk off. The thing is, I lately, due to taking in additional credit from the other side, it is tending to backfire more often than not. So my approach here will be to take risk off in the direction of risk rather than try and aggressively manage by taking in credit. So I think this should be quite safe, despite it temporarily spiking. I don't think that it would be very easy to take out all the call writers at 16,700. This morning itself, there has been about 26 lakh addition with overall 93 lakh. So between this 18.7 lakh put open interest of 16,600 and this 93 lakh of 16,700 is where we will most likely expire. So to play that range, I would take 100 points away from the put side and 50 points away from the call side maximum open interest. And I think that gives a relatively comfortable range, which will not have to be overmanaged. We'll keep you posted. Time is 9:40. Reliance, absolutely massive up move in the morning. And yeah, we'll have to see where it goes. Time is almost 10 o'clock. And something that's evident is, despite this being 16, 17 points in the money, the call option of 16650 is trading with a time value of 20 points. Not even pricing in 16700 on the upside, just the call option. Right? And yeah, it's interesting. The at the money straddle is pricing in about 60 points, in 67 points in either direction. But call option itself is not really being threatened too much. And something that's evident is there is short covering taking place in Reliance, and IT is heading up as well. Bank Nifty is very sideways. These days, Bank Nifty has definitely been the lesser of volatile indices. And that being the case, if there is like another 20 point up move from here, then there will be a short covering that is triggered. And yeah, it will lead to a temporary spike in the 16,750 calls, but I'm not going to be too quick in taking risk off on this particular position, mostly because I won't get any credit at the 16,800. So I'll have to at least let this expand to about 7 before I'm even considering taking risk off. Plus, from where it is positioned, roughly 3 times the risk of the 16,650 call is what would put this particular position at threat. So not too much of a problem. My Reliance September 2300 call is bleeding because of the relentless up move in Reliance. But that's fine. It means my shares are gaining a lot more. So I'm not going to do any adjustments also to this position. I will actually hold this position till it goes at the money. And when it is at the money, I'll look at a roll forward or any adjustment and things like that. I mean, the way you have to look at it is, so when I entered this position, the price of Reliance was 2160. So roughly, let's say buy at the price of 2160. I shorted. I have about 1,250 shares of Reliance, and I'm just taking 2160 because that is the point at which I entered this position. So this is how the position is doing. I mean, this is how you have to look at the position. So I will not be making any adjustments to this call. So from my entry, because my shares have gained, it completely offsets whatever 20 points my calls are losing. Yeah. I'll keep you posted. For now, I'm really not going to be doing much. We are holding definitely at the higher levels. There's been a decent amount of put writing and creation of 16,650 straddles. And at some point, I guess I will have to move my put up at least to 16,550 and take more credit. I will wait till this has under 3.5 or this expands till about 6 plus. Because for now, this is all right. The time is 10:25 and we've had a steady up move, mainly coming from Reliance, where the 2200 call continues to get covered to a large extent. Now, into this, we're seeing a quite large writing, about 72 lakh today itself of 16,600 put, which now has 1.2 crore open interest. And this is a monthly expiry. So I don't want to move up my puts at all. I don't want to move up my puts even to 16,550, mainly because after the dip, there's this big consensus buying and we've had a steady one-way up move. I don't realistically see these 16,750 calls ever to be at threat. So even if they do expand to 5, 5.5, I'm not too concerned by that. The only way there will be a quick expansion is if we test 16,700. There could be a quick expansion of about 3 or 4 points, but then a lot of that should fall off right after. I will regardless exit this at 7, and if that price doesn't come, then I won't be doing anything, and I would take a risk off approach into the first half. So I will not be taking in additional credit. I will not consider that 16,600 put is maximum open interest. Yes, but with an average price of close to 20. So if I enter it now at 10, 11, 12, that will give me a pretty bad situation on a reversal. And yeah, so not much to do really. Bank Nifty has been extremely sideways around 35,500. And meanwhile, it's just IT that was making a small up move. And of course, Reliance, which has been making an up move. IT now consolidating. And Reliance holding on to higher levels. So I'll keep you posted. 10:27, and the idea for today's expiry more or less is stay very, very far from wherever the market is, and see later if there is some good opportunity to take more credit. But until then, just wait. I am being a little bit overly cautious, but given that it's a monthly expiry, there's really not that much premium. It's not the best time to take too risky of a trade. I mean, if you see at the opening, what was the price of the 16,600 short straddle, then we've already basically broken that range of whatever it was pricing in. Now everyone shifted to the 16,650. And yeah, currently as well, there's really not much risk being priced in, about 62, 63. Okay, so we saw a little bit of a down move and a little bit of unwinding on the 16,600 put option. And what I did into that is I tried to move my puts up to 16,550 to sort of take advantage of the spike, and also move down my calls to 16,700. Now, this is where it's like really interesting, right? Because if you see the point at which I tried to move my put, if you see where I placed my first order, I tried to move my put when I bought the 16,500 back for 3 rupees, and I was trying to sell the 16,550 what at that point was trading for 8 rupees. But unfortunately, due to the nature of how quickly things change and how when I place my order, sometimes I little bit kill the liquidity for myself as well. I managed to keep getting worse and worse. So from 7.4, I got 6.3, then 5. I mean, 7 is 40% higher than 5, just as an FYI, right? And the price really does, it's difficult to get the price you want at larger quantity. But anyway, that happened. And I also moved down my call to 16,700 because the idea was the call was trading at about 3. And the put was trading at 8, so into the fear on the put side, try to benefit from that with quite a tight stop loss exit on the put, but it didn't work out as intended. But more or less into the IV spike, have taken in a little more credit. I've also moved in my hedges so that into the second half of the market, now that this move has come, now that this move has played out, take advantage, that is done. So more or less at this point, this short strangle position is trading at about 7.5. For whatever reason, if it extends to about 11, 12, then I will be making changes to this, either by risking off or by taking additional trade, depending on what is happening. If the move is on the downside, then I will risk off, I'll square this put off and move it down. If the risk is coming from the upside, then I will probably take additional put side trade. So and that is the idea. We'll keep you posted. Time is 1 o'clock. We've got a good 2 hours left to go for averaging, and as of now my short position has about 7.5 and my hedges are going to lose me about 1.3, so a good 6 points on full sizing that I can capture. Okay, also just to add, realistically, what is the risk in the position and how is it versus the risk that's being priced in? This 650 put is trading for 28. That's to basically triple from here and then add another 10 points for this put option to have any intrinsic value at all. So that is, I mean, very much possible, but a very low probability situation. Same thing with this call. This call has to triple and then add another 5 points from there in order to expand, in order to give intrinsic value to this call option. Of course, that is from a end of day scenario. As far as my risk management is concerned, let's say I don't want this short strangle to expand beyond 11, which is 4 points. And you have to, if you want to trade and you want to make money, you have to risk 4 points. So if you want to do that, then either one of them has to expand to about 9. So let's say one is trading at 9, the other will be trading at 2. The spread would have expanded to 11. It is basically the tripling of either of these options. So as far as probability is concerned, the trade is definitely deeply in my favor. The only issue is that in case there is a cascade, I might tend to get a little bit of slippage, but that is the cost of doing business. As far as how people are positioned, people are continuing to be heavily positioned around 16,600 and 16,700, and because we're a little bit stretched, I'm keeping my distance from the 16,600 and staying in the 16,650 instead, because that gives me more comfort. It'll be easier to manage as well. And that's more or less the summary. We'll keep you posted. It was a little bit of a down move, but so far that has more or less been bought back. A down move came from Reliance mainly, and I don't think there's too much downside to Bank Nifty below 35,500. So worst case, it'll dip till about 35,500, and that should mean that relatively these puts are safe. Okay, so now been bought back, basically whatever dip happened, it's been bought back, and that has led to a little more of a crash on the puts. And if you look at now the 16,650, the call hasn't really gained, but the put has completely crashed in value, now trading at about 36 the straddle. So that gives me very good comfort. It's not pricing in my upside, it's pricing in only about 60% to my upside strike, and on the downside, it's pricing in only about 1/3 of the risk. So that is a comfortable place to be. But it also means that now my short strangle has, once again, only 5.5 points. And given that my long strangle still has 1.25 rupees, overall, I can let either of them expand to 6 rupees. Now, so the exit on this call will be at 6 rupees, in which case the call trade will more or less be dead. I'll probably take a little more credit from the put side. The call will be moved up and that won't have any premium at all. very unlikely of situations, given how the entire situation now looks to be playing out. Keep you posted. 1.5 hours to go for averaging, and yeah, looks like people who didn't get shaken out and the dip would have really benefited on the 16650. Okay, a little bit of an up move now, coming mainly from Bank Nifty. I don't think there will be too much upside, or there is any particular reason to have a short covering triggered at 35800. Mostly because people won't let it. They would majority of people will have their stock positions and all in a range where they know it is going to settle, and it should not be too much. There isn't something that should trigger, because it's just Bank Nifty moving up. IT has been weak all day. Reliance up the gap up more or less, slightly given up the gains, given up about, let's say about 30% of the gains. So not expecting any kind of short covering up move. And I'm going to keep this position exactly as it is. But once again, of course, I could be wrong. And more or less right now, the plan is if this call goes to 3.5, then I will square it off and just roll it up. I will not be taking additional put credit, not until averaging at least. At the 16600, mostly because there is a good chance a majority of 16650 positions that were built yesterday towards the close, but before that there were a lot of positions built at 16600, 16515, 16500, and there is a good amount of cumulative open interest at 16600. So my the theory I'm working with right now is that the expiry is most likely going to be between 16600 and 16650, with a very good chance that into averaging we might be close to 16650, but we'll make a down move all the way to 16600. Very possible. That's the hypothesis I'm working for, which is why I don't want to take put set credit and have it blow up on me. I will wait. This is a comfortable position to be in. In case these calls expand, then it's another consideration to take put set credit, but it doesn't have to be right now. We'll keep you posted. We've got 51 minutes to go for averaging. And at this point, I'm just trailing a stop loss. Okay, so slight bit of a down move towards the last part with 1/2 hour to go for averaging. Bank Nifty 35,800 not happening, mostly because nobody would want that. Most positions would be at lower levels. So unless there is real some threat for short covering, and that leads to short covering on the calls, unlikely. And any last minute controlled moves will be to keep the range of 16,600 and 16,650. With 16600 once again still being a realistic closing spot. And yeah, there's really not much left. There's like 2 rupees left in my short position, and so 1 rupee 50 paisa effectively is the credit I have. So either of these expanding to about 2.5-3, I will just switch that around. And yeah, I will wait for averaging until taking any additional credit from the 16650 call or 16600 put, which is still available for about 10 rupees. No, sorry, almost 12 rupees. But I will wait. I'm not in a rush to do that. And into averaging, if once it's clear that the range is holding, I'll probably try to get another 1 point, 1.5 point, something like that. But yeah, relatively kept it safe. All expiry, I don't think there was anything at risk at any point. Okay, so the dip I was expecting has played out. So we've been pulled to 16600. I'm not expecting too much downside below 16600, but at the same time, we could kind of just hold here and pull back from here. What I've done is into this dip, because there's really no credit left on my 16700 call, I have moved my calls to 16650. Now this more or less, now the spread is trading at, let's say, 5 rupees. So if this extends, becomes 7.5 rupees, then I will just take additional credit then from the put side once there is, if there's a reversal. If we continue to head down, then there is still quite a while before I'll have to react. And that's the plan. We'll keep you posted. And more or less at this point, it's just lock in what little can be gotten without taking additional risk. One hero play, like if, you know, I had a relatively larger risk appetite, would be to short the 16600 put option at its current price. And although I'm not going to be doing that, it's just not worth the headache to have to deal with it continuing to expand if we make a temporary dip below 16600. So yeah, more or less the way I see it, I don't really care too much what's happening in the market now, because Bank Nifty will take support in this region, and eventually the cascade will halt. So right now all I care about is 4.5 points in my position. If it gains by 2.5 points, then I have to switch it around and remove risk on whichever side there seems to be risk. So we'll keep you posted. We've got 18 minutes to go for averaging. Okay, averaging has just begun, and we're basically holding 20 points above 16,600, now making a knock move. If these calls expand to like 2, I'm going to get out of them, and I'm going to wait for the first 5 to 10 minutes of averaging, and also move up my puts to 16,600. Now an absolute crap price, but at a much better situation once averaging has actually started. I'm actually moving them up right away, at least half of them. Yeah, holding perfectly in between the two strikes, so I'm going to move up all of my put options, and this will be a very tight exit situation with this trade. Okay, now basically my strangle has 2 points, and if it, this trade is more or less going to make me about 1 rupee 30 paise after, actually more than that, sorry, make me about 1 rupee 80 paise potentially. So if either of them expands to about 2.5, I will cut out of that leg. That is going to be the end of the trade. Into averaging, first 2 minutes, we made one green candle, but the way I look at it is this 16,600 call, which is trading at 28, has to go to 50, and this 16,650 put has to go to 0 for this call option to have any value. And at the first sign of a red candle, all of this will completely crash. So yeah, about 2.5 is where I'll take the exit on it. Okay, 10 minutes of averaging and some kind of attempted up move here. But after 10 minutes of holding below 16,640, it's not going to be easy to push up the average above 16,650. Very, very unlikely. This cannot, it's very difficult to make this hold value. You'll have to push the index all the way till 16,670 probably for the next 20 minutes. And then slowly there will be a chance that this has some money left over, some intrinsic value left over. Yeah, very, very unlikely. This 16,600 call trading at 33, even if you assume there's about maybe 1.5 points of time value, still you have to pull up the average by 20 points, and it's already 10 minutes has elapsed, and not once have you even attempted to go towards the strike. So yeah, this is going to be a dead leg. Anyway, 15 minutes till I have to auto square off. I have my order ready, and the wrong order. Yeah, I'm going to be taking a double diagonal both on the Nifty and Bank Nifty. I'll go through that trade once things settle down a little bit. Okay, I'm going to try and exit this 16,600 put at 10 paisa if it'll allow me. I'm going to place a limit order for 64,400 quantity. Let me see if it buys. Yeah, I don't think it'll buy. It says LTP 10, but like it won't be my order getting executed. Yeah, definitely. Now 16,650 is completely out of the cards. These options are all going to go to zero. So we'll keep you posted. Okay, nice. My put option exit is happening at 10 paisa, which means now I can try to exit the hedges Okay, we're making a little bit of an up move now. And this call is putting on a little value from, I don't know who is buying it after 15 minutes of holding below 16,500. If there is some expectation that we will actually head above 16,500, I would be quite surprised. Like, we can head above 16,500, but it is very, very unlikely that these calls will have any value at the end. So let me just see how much the average is. Cannot be 40, but right now it's getting pushed up. I'll exit this at 1.5. Below that, I'm not going to exit. I think this up move, the price will spike because there'll be some people who are buying it back. But only at 1.5, I will exit this. This is not, will not make sense to exit it at 55 paise. 16,650 put as well has 11 points in it. You can't expect that to magically become zero. So, okay, I have my basket order set up, and I'll be entering this double diagonal trade in batches of 250 on the Bank Nifty to avoid slippage, because there's monthly options involved. So hopefully not much slippage. Just check that it's executing properly. Yeah, more or less fine. That's fine. I will be doing 100 lots on the bank Nifty and 150 lots on the Nifty. That should roughly take up about 35% of my margin, and that'll give me enough margin left over to manage the position in case it starts going against me in any way. I'll go over the trade itself once I'm done executing it. I'm just checking to see if I'm getting slippage. That's about it. There's 20 paisa left in the call, so that is going to get squared off. Mostly I'll try to get it at 10 paisa. I have orders open for 10 paisa. In case it gets squared off for 10 paisa, great. If not, probably 15 paisa. So a double diagonal trade is basically like if you were to put the iron contour and the calendar spread were to have a child, it would be a double diagonal. And I'll show you how it looks. Okay, the Nifty one's going to be all over the place because of it's going to be all over the place because of how there are intraday positions. But basically, at entry, there is slippage. I'm losing currently 9,000 rupees on the position because of entry-based slippage. And this is an IV positive thing. So in case the fear in the market goes up, this will benefit. But at the same time, if there is a fall off in IV because of how the legs are spread, so it's basically you have a short straddle, right? And you have a long straddle, and they're in different expiries. And because the short straddle will decay faster, it's in a shorter dated expiry. Even if there is a fall in fear, this will benefit overall the position. So it's like a mix between, because the problem with calendar spreads is if there's a big IV crush, you can lose quite a bit because your long options are going to lose a lot. But that is mitigated by structuring it this way. I'll make a video over the weekend, like very clearly going over how the whole thing works. Oh god, okay, wait. The Nifty position is in MIS. Brilliant. This is the second time I've made this mistake. That is absolute stupidity. That was my mistake. Okay, it's anyway going to auto square me off now. Even on the calendar position, can't do anything about that. Yeah, complete stupidity, would you believe it? Ended up losing 6,000 there and 24,000 there. I gave up 30,000 to an execution error. Yeah, my mistake. Okay, this is some messed up thing. The thing is, because I'm still long these call options and I can't get out of them, I'm stuck in a situation where I can't buy either call option or put option of any expiry. My order gets rejected. I wanted to buy this. I can't on an overnight basis, mainly because the way Zerodha sees it, at least in Zerodha's logic that goes on behind the trade, since I am long these many calls, it won't let me go long because I'm not short that many options. It'll do a summation of how many calls and puts you are short together, and if you're long more options on the same instrument than that, then you can't actually do anything about it. Yes. All right, so let's see. As far as the intraday trade is concerned, managed to close 7.5 lakhs in the green, and due to two things. So one, after entering this bank Nifty double diagonal, already there's a little bit of a move, and that has led to these calls losing quite a bit of value and these puts gaining quite a bit of value, almost gained about 1.5 lakh, whereas the counter positions have only given up about 50,000. So 1 lakh is from there. And Nifty, I made the error of entering in an MIS basis. So this is fine. This was always going to happen. And Nifty, this particular position on a mark to market is showing a 22,000 loss right now. And position that I entered on MIS, that lost me about 30,000. So yeah, my last 10 minutes of trading lost me about 1.5 lakhs. It's not booked, so you can't really consider it. And now at this point, I'm carrying a naked strangle home for tomorrow. So that will be interesting depending on how things play out tomorrow. In the morning, if we open flat, or regardless of where we open, I will then buy the hedge legs. So I'm basically carrying an overnight strangle of 150 lots. So that should be interesting. Anyway, some really stupid mistakes made towards the end, but overall the expiry was all right, and more or less was in line with expectation. I hope you had a good expiry. I hope you didn't get caught off by the initial up move and or later down move. More or less held range the day. Thank you so much for watching. I will catch you tomorrow. Take care. Bye bye.
Thank you for watching. Please post any questions you have in the comment section. Also, do not forget to like and share the video and subscribe to the channel. To find us on Twitter, Telegram and Facebook, use the username NiftyBN. Also, we post some of our trades to the community tab. So do not forget to check that from time to time.